Good morning, church. Welcome to Bethel's Youth Sunday. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. For where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am with them. We will now have the processional, This Little Light of Mine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine till Jesus comes, I'm gonna let it shine. Don't let no one blow it out, but shine for Jesus. Now have our doxology, praise God from whom all blessings flow.
Thank you.
will now have our call to worship, which can be found in your bulletins. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet have been standing within your gates, O Jerusalem.
For a day thy courts are better than a thousand elsewhere. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of wickedness.
For a day in your courts is better than a thousand. For the sake of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek thy good.
They are plenty in the house of the Lord. They flourish in the courts of our God.
O Lord, I love the habitation of your house and the place where your glory dwells.
But the Lord is your temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him.
Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer.
O sing unto the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. I will sing of loyalty and of justice to you, O Lord. I will sing.
We will now have the hymn of praise. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. And Jesus wants all of us to be happy and worship him in spirit and in truth. So let's sing and give him our best praise. Now have the welcome by Sister Kamaya Burgess.
Stand in front of us. Put in front of us so we can see it.
Can you see it?
Yeah.
Okay. Good morning, church, and we say welcome, welcome, welcome. And I hope you enjoy the service today. Thank you.
We will now have the invocation and intercessory prayer by Brother Micaiah Tucker. Man always ought to pray and not faint. Prayer is the key. Prayer is power. And let's join Brother Micaiah Tucker as we approach the throne of grace.
Dear God, thank you for waking us up today. Thank you for feeding and clothing us. We rejoice and praise your name. We pray for other kids and adults who are poor and may not have everything they need. God, we pray for the homeless that they will have lots of hope in you. Please stop people from using drugs. God, we now pray for all for other children's families here at Bethel. Be with us in this service today, especially Reverend Larry Smith. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Peace, everyone. Let's say the Lord's Prayer together. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you.
Now I have the scripture by Brother Noriko Farbert.
Mm-hmm.
in church. I'll be reading from Genesis chapter 37, verse 25 to 28 in the New International Version. As they sat down to eat their meal, they looked up and saw a caravan of Ishmaelites coming from Gilead. Their camels were loaded with spices, balm, and myrrh, and they were on their way to take them down to Egypt. Judah said to his brothers, "What will we gain if we kill our brother and cover up his blood? Come, let's sell him to the Ishmaelites and not lay our hands on him. After all, he is our brother, our own flesh and blood." His brothers agreed. So when the Midianite merchants came by, his brothers pulled Joseph out of the cistern and sold him for 20 shekels of silver to the Ishmaelites, who took him from Egypt. May the Lord add a blessing to this reading of this holy word.
Walk, walk, walk in the light. Walk, walk,
before our pastor comes with announcements, I'm going to get everybody actively involved and get your blood pumping by singing, "Whose side are you leaning on? Whose side are you leaning on? Whose side are you clapping on? Whose side are you dancing on? Whose side are you shouting on?"
Let's give our Sunbeam Choir another clap this morning. Amen, amen. Well done to our young people this morning. And they did very well yesterday at our Sunday school conventions, and we say congratulations and thank you to all those persons who were in attendance. And if I have it correct, Sister Victoria, they received the award for the most present. Amen, amen. That wouldn't have been possible without all those who were there on time for registration. For only those who were there for registration are counted. But Bethel was well represented yesterday. And we say thank you and congratulations to all the teachers. As some of our teachers taught during the Sunday school convention. So we say thank you to all of you. Celebrations for this week on Friday the 30th. Brother Eugene Lightborn will be celebrating 91 years. Amen. To God be the glory. Brother Eugene, if you're watching by Zoom, we say happy birthday and may God continue to bless you. Over the last week, our brother Calvin Bummy Simons and his wife, Sister Valerie Simons, celebrated 65 years of marriage. And to them, we say happy belated anniversary. May God continue to bless and keep you. There will be an official board tomorrow evening at 7 o'clock p.m. I'm asking all members of the official board if you can please be present. I'm going to ask Kalichi if she will come forth at this time to make an announcement.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Next week, Friday, we have the IROC Awards, where we celebrate one person from each church. And this year, we have decided to nominate Noriko Furbit.
Stand up, Noriko.
And we have three different categories. So Noriko Farbitz Award is the 25-29 award, and I will just read it. This award highlights youth who have used their gifts and talents, whether on the stage or on the field or in the classroom, for the glory of God. So Noriko, your church salutes you for all your accomplishments, both in football and in school, and as well as on to Berkeley. Noriko will be graduating Whitney Institute next week, and he's on to the Berkeley Institute.
Amen.
So please come and support Noriko and Bethel as well. Thank you.
In terms of tickets, if you can please call the church office with your payment, then Bethel would make one payment to the conference. So please see Sister Karen before Thursday, by Thursday. See Sister Karen by Thursday, and we will get your tickets for you. While we're on our young people, today we're celebrating the graduating class of 2023. And I'm going to call our young people's names, and I will read their accomplishments for this school year. Malaya Taka, Malaya. Come, Malaya. Malia. Malia has graduated from Warwick Preschool and will be attending Paget Primary. Malia? Malia? That's for you, sweetheart, and we say congratulations and all the best to you as you go to primary school, okay? Maddox Smith. Maddox graduated from Avocado Lodge Preschool and will be attending Elliott. Charlie Edmee is going from Happy Valley Child Care Center and will be going to Victor Scott Preschool.
Amen.
Chaz Edmee will be graduated from Victor Scott Preschool and will be attending West Pembroke. Thais, Pam, if you can come for her. She will be graduated from Somerset Primary and will be attending Sands Middle School. And while she's here, also Egypt graduated from Temple and will be employed at Appleby. Noriko, as we heard, graduated from Whitney and will be attending Berkeley Institute. Destiny Smith will be graduating from the Berkeley Institute and will be attending the Bermuda College. Michaela Nesbitt. Michaela graduated from the Bermuda College and she has been selected to be one of the models in a New York fashion show in September. So we say congratulations to Michaela. Bridget Basden graduated from Shaw University and will be going on to complete her master's. Yeah. Sasha Griffin graduated from CMU College and is seeking employment in the child and youth care profession. Amen.
Then a special mention, Sister Letitia Williams has completed her two-year teacher's mentorship program, and she is teaching at Avocado Pre-Lodge. Just coming. And I was just given one more name, and I will get a certificate for her. Kamaya, will be going on to St. George's Prep. So we say congratulations to Kamaya, and we will get you your certificate. To all our graduates, we say well done, congratulations, and may God continue to bless and keep you. I can't read lips, sweetheart. Okay, congratulations, congratulations. Get me his name and we can add him to the list as well. Okay, congratulations, Zayden. Amen.
Today there will be the celebration and homegoing of Brother Otterbell Simmons today at St. Paul's. And the service is available on Twitch and on Radio FM 102.7 and 107.5. These are announcements. We're asking if you will take your bulletins home. And let's make every effort to support our church. It's now time for us to give of our tithes and our offerings as our ushers come. And we've got a junior usher this morning, Ellie Lynn. Well done, sweetheart. God bless you. God bless you. Our gracious and our eternal God, for all you have blessed us with, for all, God, you have given unto us. Father, we come this morning to give of our best unto you. God, we ask that you will pour out your blessing on every hand and every heart that gives in accordance to your word. In the name of Jesus the Christ, amen.
life we give thee.
I'd like to recognize our visitors this morning that are here with us today, and I see Sister Charmaine's mother. Good to see you again. God bless you. God bless you. Any other visitors with us that wish to stand and recognize and share your name?
Courtney Roberts. Yes, Kamaya's mom.
Candy Roberts, Kamaya's nan.
Amen, sir.
Tyrone Joffa, visiting from Freeport, Bahamas.
Amen to all of you this morning. We say, may God bless you, and it's our prayer that indeed you will be blessed. We know that our young ones have already blessed our hearts, but God has a message in store just for you today. And we say thank you for coming, and God bless.
We will now have the Sermonic Selection by Bethel Sunbeam Choir, and then we'll have the sermon from none other, Reverend Larry Smith.
Jesus, deep down in my heart, I love you, Jesus, deep down in my heart. Talking about a deep, deep, down, down, deep down in my heart. Talking about deep, deep, down, down, deep down in my heart. I love you, Jesus, deep down in my heart.
Deep, deep.
Good morning, church. I could actually sing a little song similar to what the kids were singing. I love you, Bethel, deep down in my heart. And I'll stop right there. And the reason why I said that, Pastor, my wife went to Chicago yesterday. I dropped her to the airport, and then my youngest son, who lives in Chicago, calls and says, why are you not here, Osa? So I had to say to him, I love you too, but I'm preaching on Sunday. And so my commitment really is in Bermuda and Bethel. Donna can take care of herself, and he'll see me sometime, the other, before I die. Amen? Amen. I actually struggle with this sermon, Pastor, and that's unusual, but nonetheless. The scripture was read, and this reminds me of what we are going through right now in Bermuda. It's like a family dispute. And I could have had about three titles. The title is Rejected but Respected. But the second and third one I thought about, Down but Not Out, and Trouble Don't Last Always. And so this family affair involves a young man named Jacob, and we should know about this. It's a popular thing in the Bible. The story of Jacob begins when he was sold in slavery. It's considered one of the darkest in the entire Bible. Among other things, it shows the depth of evil and hatred in the human heart. And that came to me strongly because of the situation we have right here. I think of young man just going by, and of late, we haven't had anything of late, but we think of young men that have just gone by and they shot their colleagues or shot their cousins. And Bermuda, just when I was doing this, I thought about Bermuda. How could brothers do this to one another? It's kind of like a mystery to me, and I'm assuming it's a mystery to each and every one of us. But it shouldn't be. Because if you look at Genesis prior to this situation, you'll find there was a conflict between Cain and Abel. So there has been conflicts in this Bible, family conflicts, for a very, very long time. And I'm praying in Jesus' name that the young man that's to my left and these little ones right in front of me, that they'll hear what we have to say today, and prayerfully they'll stay on the right path. Amen? We pray that they will stay on the right path. Because trouble doesn't last always. At the time of this episode, Joseph was 17 years of age. And this is the beginning. And was the favorite son of the father. And so sometimes you can say, well, it's perhaps not even Joseph's fault that he became the favorite. We all have favorites. I don't care whether you've been a mother or father for a long, long time, but I'm convinced that if you have more than one child, there has to be a favorite. It's human nature to have a favorite. I'm a fine example, being the favorite because I was the last boy. And I'm remindful quite often, because we have a joke about it. My middle brother just came up and struck me one day, and I said, why? He said, because you're the youngest.
So we have to train them up, because this is not just today. Church, what goes in that Bible of ours is happening today. So this 17-year-old was the favorite son of the father. His name is Joseph. No matter how far Egypt was from Jacob's land, Joseph was going to be thrown into a whole new world, because his brothers actually sold him into slavery. A bunch of Ishmaelites, I think that's what they're called, were riding by, coming by, and they didn't know what to do. The brothers had a little debate, and one of them said, we need to kill him, and then one of the brothers had some common sense and says, no, let's not kill him, let's sell him. And that's how he was sold, and he went over to Egypt. But no matter how far Egypt was from Jacob's land, Joseph was going to be thrown into a whole new world. And that's what happens when we mistreat our children. That's what happens when there's problems in the family unit. Someone gets all bent out of shape, and you know, there you go. We have trouble in the house. He wouldn't be bringing back any bad reports about his brothers. And that's where it began, because he was like a telltale. Every time he had 10 brothers. Every time his brothers did something, Jacob would go and tell on them to mommy and daddy. And we know that. I mean, you got children. We know that there's a telltale in the family. I was one, so I'm not afraid to say that I was one. Mom, Poppy did A, B, C, and D. And I guess that's why I got that bang one day, and I didn't know why I got it. You see what I'm saying? It's human nature. And because I didn't know what I was going to preach, this was the only thing that I thought of. So God put this in my spirit. Go and talk about Joseph. And Joseph had a difficult life. After being sold, he was put into prison. As it turned out, call this God's providence. God always has a way to step in at the right time. And I want you guys and girls, young men, to know that trust in the Lord. There's a scripture, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding, and in all your ways acknowledge him. And he promises to direct your pathway. So Joseph left it to God. He was bought by Potiphar. This man was an officer of Pharaoh, and thus he seemed to be in relatively high rank. Nothing is said about how much Potiphar gave for Joseph, or they navigated the language barrier. But no matter what, Joseph seemed to have resigned to the fact that living the rest of his life in Egypt, at Potiphar's house, no relatives, nobody else to tease, no daddy, no mommy. But we don't know how long Joseph stayed and or served Potiphar, but he eventually gained Potiphar's trust. And from that trust that he gained from Potiphar, Potiphar gave him a little rank. Everything after that had to kind of like go through Joseph. God had led these two together, and God was blessing Potiphar because of Joseph. Sometimes you have to really say that my trouble is not going to last always. And it will not last always, young man and young women, if you trust in God. And I like the song, actually, trouble don't last always. I'm so glad that trouble don't last always. But trouble did find Joseph. Trouble found Joseph. And so he was put in jail. But God had other ideas. Whenever a believer is being challenged and believer is doing and has done the right thing, we just need to trust in God. Yes, everybody has a best friend. And sometimes we like to go to our best friend. You guys all have a best friend. And sometimes you may go to your best friend, but your best friend is not named God. Because God had other ideas for Joseph. Joseph was blessed to interpret dreams, and that's what really got him in trouble. He interpreted dreams, and he did so for each man, the butler and the baker. Joseph listened to the dreams, told them, man, exactly what he dreamt about and what it really meant to them. And each prediction came true. So when he was explaining the dreams to them, it was not just a dream. It was the truth. God had given him a blessing. And God has given each and every one of you a blessing of some sort. But you need to use it to God's grace. Don't use it against your so-called enemies. Because as I say, trouble don't last always, so just give it to God. Amen? And so he ended up going into prison. But trouble don't last always. The butler was supposed to, let me go back with you. Joseph, in that dream, helped the butler to keep his job. Regrettably, the other prisoner, he was killed. Joseph put in a good word for him, but when he got released, be careful of the friends that you have, because when he got released, he didn't think any more of Joseph. Joseph did all this for his friend, the butler, because they were prisoners together. But the butler got the job, and Joseph had to stay another 2 years because the butler said, you're on your own, bro. That's what happens when you trust supposed to be friends. I use the word supposed to be friends, because if your friends are that good, a friend would not leave you. A friend would not leave you stranded. I want you guys to know that when you create friends, do not abandon them when things go wrong. And if you see one of your friends going wrong, stop him or her before trouble starts. Pharaoh said to his servants, "Can we find such a one as this is, a man in whom the Spirit of God is?" That's his boss now. That's what he saw. That's what he saw in Joseph. "I see a man who has a Spirit of God." And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, "For as much as God hath shown thee all this, there is none so discreet and wise as thou art," or as he is, or as he was. "You shall be over my house." He was put over the house of his boss. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, "See, I have set thee over all the land of Egypt." So it was not only the head of the household and make sure the household ran how it should be. He now is a bigger over the entire land of Egypt. Pharaoh took off his ring from his hand and put it on Joseph's finger and arrayed him in vestures, fine linen, and put a gold chain about his neck. All I'm saying that there's going to be times in our lives, young man and young women, young boys and young girls, that you're going to get some challenges. You're going to get some people that do not come to Sunday school. You're going to get some friends that do not come to church, and they're going to try to lure you away into the streets. But trust in the Lord. Trust in your parents. Trust in the Lord and trust in your parents. Sometimes, you know, you think that your friend is your friend, but when things go kind of wrong, just like Joseph that was in the prison with two other people, and one of them got out and one of them was killed, but the one that got out was supposed to speak up for him, but he got his own job and he forgot all about Joseph. And today that is happening to young men and young women like you are. So analyze who your friends are going to be or who you want to be your friends. And mommies and daddies, you also have to check out who their friends are as well. Amen? Don't hear it. Amen. My little one, the youngest one, is all the way in Chicago, and he contacts me quite often. I'm even checking on him, and he's just saying, "Papa, I'm okay." I said, "But you're getting at that age now." And of course, it's a Smith, so God help him. Okay, Reverend Roosh just shot me one, but I would have to take it on the chin. Apple didn't fall far from the tree. So. Now, when Jacob saw that there was a corn in Egypt, Jacob said unto his sons, "Why don't you look one upon another?" And he says, "Behold, I have heard that there's corn in Egypt. So you guys go over to Egypt and you buy some corn. And I think you must know this story. The 10 brothers get into Egypt, and who should they meet up with, but they don't know who he is. And that is Jacob. Joseph, I'm sorry, that is Joseph. Don't know who he is. That's how bad things got. And that's how long that he was away from his family. The brothers didn't even know him, even though they put him in a pit. Joseph's brother Jacob did not let him go, for he said, let something mischief befall him. We can't kill him. Let something else befall him. At least he had some common sense, because the other brothers wanted to kill him. And when the butler was, when that was all done, Joseph provided, Joseph proved that he was the brother, and then they didn't know what to do. In his position to save their lives, 5 more years of famine was on the way. And after this, Jacob and all the family resettled in Egypt. But before that happened, he wouldn't sell them anything because he wanted to see his younger brother. And so they had to go back home, and when the food ran out, they had to come back to Egypt. And he would not allow them to return to Egypt unless the daddy sent his youngest brother. So what are we saying? Joseph's life seemed to stop when his own brothers sold him into slavery. He kept at it, kept trusting in God. Even though I'm in slavery, even though we may get into whatever kind of mischiefs and troubles of life that we face today, if you know the God that you serve, if you know the God that said, yes, I accept you as one of my children, God will take care of you. And God will see that your trouble is not going to last always. And God used him in that capacity to provide food for many other people, because he kept it. He kept it, and he kept trusting in God. And if I don't leave you with anything, I just need to leave you with that scripture. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and it's easy to memorize. And lean not to your own understanding, but in all your ways and everything that you do, acknowledge God, and he will. Somebody say he will. He will direct your pathway. Trust in the Lord. I had about 3 titles. Sometimes we can get down. That's the other problem. That's the other title. Sometimes we can get down, but we're not out. Why? Because we want trust in the Lord. And the other title was going to be trouble don't last always. Why? Because we trust in the Lord. And if you trust in the Lord, your troubles will not last always. I want to talk to somebody that may not even have accepted God yet. And I want to just say this to you. Trust in God. Because even families nowadays will abandon you. You may not have a brother like I had. We're the best of friends, by the way. You may not have a brother like I had that just struck me for the sake of striking me, but nonetheless, still love him because we both trusted in God. We were both marching up here every Sunday, every Sunday. In fact, he used to bring me because he was older. And I remember we both went to this altar and we put our trust in God, even at that youthful age. Even at that youthful age, teach them who this God is. Teach them who this God is. Bring them to the altar and share with them the goodness of God. Is there one? Is there one who's even slipped out? Renew your strength in the Lord. Renew your position in God. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus for your word. I pray in Jesus' name that the word has found a lodging place in someone's spirit. But I pray that your spirit will fall afresh on each and every one of us here today and those that may be listening in cyberspace. And I pray that we'll see a change in someone's life. So I thank you for the opportunity to present to you this word today. And I ask your blessing and your covering over all these young folk that's here today, the smaller young and the teenagers. Just encamp around them each and every day in the going and in the coming to keep danger away from them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Trust in the Lord, I'm gonna trust in the Lord, I'm gonna trust in the Lord till I die. I'm gonna trust in the Lord. I'm gonna trust in the Lord. I'm gonna trust in the Lord till I die. Come on, let's sing it. Trust in the Lord. I'm gonna trust in the Lord. I'm gonna trust in the Lord till I die. I'm gonna trust in the Lord. I'm gonna treat everybody right. I'm gonna treat everybody right. Till I die. I'm gonna treat everybody right. Till I die. I'm going to try. I'm gonna trust till I die. Gonna trust in the Lord. I'm gonna trust in the Lord. I'm gonna trust in the Lord till I die. Amen.
We will now have our vote of thanks by Sister Malia Taco.
The Young People's Department Director, Kalisha Jones, Todd Church School Superintendent, Victoria May, members and friends of Bethel, we thank everyone here today for supporting our youth service. Reverend Larry Smith, we especially thank you for speaking to us today on the topic rejected but respected. Trouble does not last always, and to trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Again, we say thank you. Have a great afternoon, and go in peace.
Amen. Let's give all our young people a hand this morning. This is their training ground, where they learn to speak publicly, where they learn to just present themselves before a congregation. So to all our young people and to our worship leader this morning, Keziah, we say a job, well done, well done, well done.
We will now have our benediction and closing song, Let It Rise.
Amen. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God our Savior be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now, henceforth, and forevermore. And the people of God say, Amen. That's the church. Say the church.